Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you a part of the AI assistant inside of Rise that I think is one of the coolest parts, and that is the magic text import. We're going to talk about that, how to actually take some of the text that may not be coherent or just may not be organized or something like that, paste it into this magic import, and then how Rise handles it and just converts it into a block. So let's go ahead and dive in here. I'm going to go into my Rise 360 course. This one is just a sample cooking 101 course that I have here. Now you could set up things inside of the Rise Assistant that will help make some of this logic be a whole lot easier. I go through a little bit more in depth for everything on the AI Assistant. You can check out that video here. But one thing just as a reminder, if you go into AI Assistant and go into AI settings here, this allows you to upload source content. This to me is like one of the biggest benefits of the AI assistant is you can use source material. When I used to work at Amazon, I had a lot of boring documentation that I would have to sift through in order to get the right process. But being able to upload that type of documentation here and use that to create an interactive block would be amazing. I'm not there anymore, but it would have been incredible for me to be able to just sift through that documentation. So that is one thing I just wanted to point out. But there is something else that we can do here. I'm gonna go in and just create a quick page called Test 3, and then I'll hit Enter, and let's create a lesson here. Now, inside of this lesson, this is where I can come in and start to add some content. So I can either click on AI Block, and then I can generate it some content through the source material there, or if I come to the AI Assistant, this is the Magic Text Import. And in the Magic Text Import, will basically allow you to copy and paste in the text, and then it will create an interaction for you. Now you can specify what type of interaction you want it to create. So the different options that are available now are process, accordion, tabs, and soon will be sorting, flashcards, and knowledge checks. You can see it's kind of suggesting the structure, what you would do, structure, content, and then intro, title, description, step title, and so forth. I found in my testing that I don't have to be perfect in this. So what I did is I created just a simple step. Here's some instructions. Here's number one for creating a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. And so I just wanted to keep it very basic. These are instructions for creating a peanut butter jelly sandwich. So I have my description, I have this, and so forth. And this is kind of like an intro title. So all I have to do is copy and paste that into that block. Again, you don't have to really be too structured, just enough for it to be able to get the idea here. But if I click on Generate Block now, it's gonna take all of that content without me having to go in and add block one, add block two, add block three, copy and paste and stuff like that. It will generate it for you. That alone is a huge time saver. Oh my goodness, just being able to go in and just copy in a big block and have it automatically separate out that content. Yes, I am a nerd. I get excited about this kind of stuff. So you can see here already it has like, there's my description. And if I click on next, there's step number two. And I could change that. This could be an introduction. So right here, gather your ingredients. There's been times where I've done this and it does do the intro, but for some reason, this one, it did not. So let's go ahead and just quickly copy and paste that in. So we're gonna just take this title, move the title up here, and then just add that. So sometimes it'll do it, sometimes it doesn't. Again, it's not incredibly perfect, but at least gives you the idea here. But right now, just going through step by step. So step one, gather your ingredients. Step two, lay out the bread. So just copying and pasting in that text, now I don't have to individually go in and add the steps. Because before, I'd have to go into edit here, and I'd have to go edit the step, and I'd have to copy in the title, then I'd have to copy in the description, and so forth. So let's try one more thing. If I click on AI Assistant, let's go to Magic Text Import, and instead, let's do accordion. Now I'm gonna copy and paste in the same thing. Let's get all of the text. So I'm gonna go back into here, and I'm gonna go ahead and paste that in here and click on Generate Block. Now it will generate the block for an accordion. So automatically right here, we have the different steps, which I could probably add on step one, step two, and so forth. And then I expand that out, and there is my description. I probably want to get rid of description there in this case. So maybe even in the text before I copy and paste in the description, I can get rid of that. But you can see how quickly that did it, but instead of me having to go into edit mode and add the steps here. So just an incredible feature that will save you a whole lot of time if you just wanted to type or copy and paste in the different steps from your storyboard, paste them into Rise here, and use the magic, and it really is magic, use the magic text import to be able to create these different interactions. So just something exciting. I didn't cover too much in depth in my previous video, but I wanted to dive into that a little bit. If you want to check out more, head on over to my website at learningdojo.ninja. You can check out all previous blog posts. You can also download free templates. You can check out full courses covering everything from A to Z in Articulate Storyline 360, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Adobe Captivate, Camtasia, Custom Squirm, and HTML5 Video. Also, I have a new community, so if you head on over to the templates, you can download these templates in Storyline and XAPI. You can also check out my blog and filter out to different topics as well, a little bit easier. You can also check out my full courses here as well. That's all I have for today, so thanks everyone, and I'll see you next time.